Welcome to Sorosar Classes. This tutorial is on monopolistic competition. It is part 2 because it is the continuation of the previous tutorial. In case of any queries with regard to this particular tutorial, you can contact us on this number. And now we are also available also online, so you do check in our website, which is www.sorosarclasses.com. Now previously we have solved, for this particular question, we have solved the first two parts. So today, right now in this particular tutorial, we will be focusing on part 3 and part 4. So explain the part 3 says, the question is, explain the effect of a fall in wages in part 2 above on profits in the short run. So the answer is very simple. We had this diagram before. So if there is a fall in the wages, then the same procedure will follow. That means average cost. So let me tell you. So if again wages fall, that means wage bill fall, that means cost of production falls, that means if cost of production, then average cost curve will be affected. And how it will be affected? It will be shifted downwards, as shown in the previous tutorial. So it will be shifted downwards, and when shifted downwards, so as average cost is getting affected, marginal cost will also get affected. So given reduction in wages, firms will enjoy, or this particular firm say, firm will enjoy super normal profit. Why? Because P will be greater than C. And if you want the diagram, you can refer to the our previous tutorial on this particular question. Okay, now let us move on to the last question. So this previous tutorial is the explanation, and here will be the diagram. Here is the diagram, so you can refer. So now the last question is asking us, explain what will happen to the demand and profits in the long run. So this is the key word. So all these were short run phenomena. So now we are actually, so in the short run, we have seen there can be super normal profits. So how the curve will look like in the long run, let's see. So let me insert one more page for you. Okay. So I have drawn two axes where Q I am measuring on the horizontal and P on the vertical axis. So you know this. Now let us make first the average revenue. This will be my marginal revenue. I hope you know that average revenue in case of linear, and the production function will be linear, then the average revenue. Okay, so this will be only be lasting when you have linear, you are working with linear functions. So average revenue, marginal revenue will be half of average revenue. Okay, only with linear functions. Okay, this is valid. Now next you will have, let us make the marginal cost curve. So this is our MC, this is the point. Okay, so now I'll make the So I have to redo this. Just a second. Okay, so marginal cost curve this, and this is my average cost curve. Okay, so now this is the point where the average cost curve is tangent to average revenue. So this will give me the price, say P1. And this is the quantity. Okay, now what happens is that in the long run, if you have super normal profits, now just imagine that in an industry there are super normal profit prevailing, you being a firm, you will enter the market, so there will be entry. However, if there is loss in the short run, there will be exit. So what we find in the long run is that there will be normal profit prevailing if we want no entry or exit to take place. And how this will happen? This can only happen when price is equal to the average cost. Because if the price is greater than the average cost, then you know that there will be super normal profit. And if it is less, then there will be loss. So, in the long run, this condition will prevail. Okay. And what does this mean? This means is that there will be no incentive to cut down the price. So, no incentive to cut down the price. Why there is no incentive? Because if you cut down the price, say you choose a price lower than P1, say P2, that means you are trying to increase your Q. So you can see that any Q greater than Q1, you can see that marginal cost will be greater than marginal revenue. So that means you are incurring a loss. So you will never do this. And since you will not cut down the prices, what happens is that there is no incentive to entry or exit. Since you are not making a loss, you will not exit. Since you are not making any super normal profit, you will not enter. And this will denote the long run market equilibrium. Okay, so in the long run market equilibrium, we know that the firms earn zero profit, there is no incentive to enter, and there is no incentive to exit either. Okay, so I hope this tutorial, so this is the end for this particular tutorial. If you find our videos helpful, if they really help you, then please like our videos, share and subscribe. It means a lot to us, and we will return back to you with more interesting videos on some interesting topics. And for time being, let me thank you. Thank you for watching, and stay tuned for our upcoming videos.